"We shall have to abandon this attempt, I think," said Glinda. "The easiest way to raise the island would be for us to gain admittance to the dome and then descend to the basement and see in what manner Coo ee oh made the entire island sink or rise at her command. It naturally occurred to me that the easiest way to gain admittance would be by having the boat take us into the basement through the marble door from which Coo ee oh launched it. But there must be other ways to get inside the dome and join Ozma and Dorothy, and such ways we must find by study and the proper use of our powers of magic." "It won't be easy," declared the wizard, "for we must not forget that Ozma herself understands considerable magic, and has doubtless tried to raise the island or find other means of escape from it and failed." "That is true," returned Glinda. "But Ozma's magic is fairy magic, while you are a wizard and I am a sorceress. In this way the three of us have a great variety of magic to work with, and if we should all fail, it will be because the island is raised and lowered by a magic power none of us is acquainted with. My idea, therefore, is to seek, by such magic as we possess, to accomplish our object in another way." They made the circle of the dome again in their boat, and once more saw Ozma and Dorothy through their windows and exchanged signals with the two imprisoned girls. Ozma realized that her friends were doing all in their power to rescue her, and smiled in encouragement to their efforts. Dorothy seemed a little anxious, but was trying to be as brave as her companion. After the boat had returned to the camp, and Glinda was seated in her tent, working out various ways by which Ozma and Dorothy could be rescued, the wizard stood on the shore, dreamily eyeing the outlines of the great dome which showed beneath the clear water, when he raised his eyes and saw a group of strange people approaching from around the lake.